What's up, gang? It's your boy Q, back with another video, man. And today, I'm coming at y'all with the story time. Y'all read the title, man. I was finna go over my worst whooping, man. My worst whooping, bro. I was finna get this little Fortnite gameplay. Nah, keep in mind, I ain't been on the game in like 2 months, so not too much, bro. I'm a little rusty. But hey, we finna get into this thing. Yeah. All right, bro. I'm here, bro. So I'm gonna get to the story time when I land and get my loot situated. I'm gonna go to Honey Hills. I'm gonna go somewhere secluded, like maybe like not be sure. I might go over here. Like, I'm gonna go to Chippy Shafts. So I'm a little rusty, bro. So not too much, bro. But we finna get into this thing, man. Comment down below if y'all like season 10 so far, bro. I only played like 4 games, and I ain't been on the game in like 2 months. I've been meaning to drop this video before the lyric print video, but the game had an update and stuff. So yeah. So I don't like season 10 like that, cause when a robot be shooting them little rockets and you trying to build, that's crazy. Like, come on now, bro. That's not fair. That's not fair. Like Fortnite, what are you doing? But I'ma land over here at this little house over here. Hopefully I get something good out of the little chest and stuff like that. They still got zip lines in the game. It's crazy. Alright, man, so I got 2 story times and 1. I guess you're gonna call it that. 2 story times and 1. Ooh, a pump. I'm gonna pick this up. I don't know what even a pump is. What is gun is? Combat shotgun, I think it is. So 2 story times and 1. So the first worst whooping, I guess you could say, it was in second grade, because my teacher was Miss Young. I remember it. So I had a friend, his name was John. I know it's a regular white boy name. His name John. So he was a nasty little kid. He had an apple, right? And he was, what you calling? He was eating it in the bathroom. I know it sounds weird, but he was eating his apple in the bathroom, bro. So dude ate the apple, got done, and threw it down the toilet, thinking it was gonna be all right. So everybody in the bathroom thinking it's gonna be all right, like, all right, it's gonna flush down the toilet, ain't nothing happening. But nah, the toilet had other plans. Talking about the steam back blowed up, bruh. Doodoo all over the toilet overflowed. Talking about there was some damage done. So everybody in the bathroom, you know, the little kids be like, ooh, you're finna get in trouble. Nah, that's what I said. Dude ran back to the class, cause we was buddies. Dude ran back to the class, like, you know how, like, when you go to the bathroom, you gotta take a partner or something like that? Yeah, I was that dude. It was weird, but. So, dude ran back to the classroom. I'm walking, like, why is this dude running? Like, I ain't finna snitch on him. So, dude, what's called? Hold up. So, dude snitched, right? He ran back to the classroom, like, quit through the apple on the toilet, Miss Young. And I was like, oh no. Dang, so that fall damage. But hey, so he was like, quit, Miss Young, quit through the apple down the toilet. And then I was like, you dirty dog, you just lied. And I was like, I threw the apple down the toilet. And of course, she ain't believe me, cause you know, I was a bad little kid, I had a reputation. That's why you gotta do good in school, kids. And then, so he lied, talking about, I threw the apple down the toilet. And I was screaming at the top of my lungs. Like, you know how you deny it? Nuh-uh, or little kids. Yeah, I know what you're talking about. I know. Hold up. What? Man, this is getting trash. But all right, now we're finna get to story time. So he ran back to class and snitched. I was like, Miss Young, quit through the apple on the toilet. And I was like, no, I didn't. And she's like, quitting? Go to the office. Ain't no little, them long referrals that they give you. She signed that, handed it to me. And guess who she had walk me down there? The dude that snitched on me, bruh. She had walked me down there. So I'm feeling some type of way, bro. Like if I was bigger, I would've really stole off on this dude. Like, he really just lied, like. So they put me down there, bruh. I go to the principal's office. I'm telling him I didn't do it. So they called John, they called this dude back in there. He sits down, I was like, with a straight face, lied straight through his teeth, bruh, and said, I threw the apple down the toilet. Now, you know how they have the cameras like right outside the bathroom? So you can see when they walk out. You can see when, what you call, when you walk in the bathroom. And they said that I was walking out casual, so I must have did something. Like, what kind of stuff is that? So they got my mom on the phone, bro. Miss Lowe, your son Quentin Black is in the office for clogging the toilet system. He threw an apple down there, and then I'm still saying, no, I didn't. So my mom was like, all right, I'm gonna handle him when I get home. Ain't even let me speak my side of the story. So yeah, you know I'm finna get in trouble when I get home, but this ain't even it yet. The counselors, they brought the counselors in, like, come on, why you gotta bring them in here? So they was like, if you don't like fruit, there's a trash can in the bathroom. You don't have to throw it away in the toilet. And I'm sitting there looking at him like, dude, really? So I get home and my mom, well, my stepdad, he asked me, guess what? He was like, so how was your day at school? And I'm like, so I'm thinking he didn't get the call because he was at work. So I'm thinking he ain't get no call, so I'm good. So I'm like, good, I had a good day at school. I told him, like, you know how you're like trying to impress them with the things y'all did at school? Yeah, I try to do that, it ain't work. My mom walk out the corner with a belt, bro. She was like, drop the pants, boy, you know what time it is. She brought one of these belts out. Oh my God, bro, my heart went from here. Yeah, I think your heart right there. It went from here all the way down to the bottom of my stomach, bro. I felt sick. Like, y'all know what I'm talking about? Yeah, everybody been there in their life before. I know they have. So I'm sitting there, like, I'm really finna get a whooping because this little white dude lied on me. So you already know, I had to drop the pants, bro. I had to. Like, I'm finna get a whooping, bro. Like, she ain't playing around, and she ain't playing no games. Like, she is not playing. So, you know, I had to do what I had to do, bro. So I drop him. She says, turn around. And you know how you put your hands behind your butt to, you know, like, block the wax? Yeah, in this case, it didn't work. It did not work. I'm talking about, she was smacking my legs, my arms. Arms was on fire. Like, y'all know what I'm talking about, bro. And then, worst thing was, she sent me outside. And keep in mind, this is like as soon as we go back to school. Now, I ain't get suspended or nothing like that, luckily, because I would have really been mad. Like, I would have got a worse whooping than what I got. So she tear me up, bruh. Like, hold up. Like, she's like, hold up. Come on. She's like, she going crazy. And then I'm like this, like I'm holding, I'm squealing and stuff, bruh. Like, that ain't even work, bruh. I'm screaming, talking about, stop, I'm not gonna do it again. Even though I ain't even do it. Like, that was really crazy, bruh, how my own friends snitched on me. That's how you really know your friends ain't really your friends when they come down to it. That's the day I learned that. So, hold on. So, we get in there, and she's swinging, bro. Like, I swear this whooping lasted like 10 minutes, bro. I swear it did. Like, she going crazy on my butt talks, man. My butt cheeks. She going crazy. So, it finally ends, and then guess what? I got two whoopings in one day. And then my stepdad come around the corner with another belt, bruh. Except this one, his work belt. And it was black and leather, bruh. And it had like the little holes, like the big little holes. Hold up, the belt drop. And it had like the big little holes, bruh. I'm talking about like, these belts ain't no joke. I'm talking about like, it's like this thick. I'm talking about like, he going crazy on my butt cheeks too, smacking my legs. I'm talking about like, I'm on the ground, they still hit me. And it's like, and you know that one line? This is gonna hurt me more than it hurt you. Like, come on, like, I'm the one getting a whooping. So that happened, and then I go to school the next day. I'm an ISS, chilling for the next 3 days. No, I got my butt cheeks whooped, but I ain't telling nobody. Now, you already know, like, when you get a butt cheeks whooping, bro, like, when you get your butt whooped, dude, you screaming and crying, and you're like, I'm finna leave, bro, I'm finna leave. Like, you ever had one of those kind of whoopings? It was that kind of whooping, bro. It was that kind of whooping. So we go. The next day roll around. A dude had an audacity to laugh at me, bruh. And then he had an audacity to laugh at me, bruh. And then I come back out of ISS. You go back to your class. You know how it's awkward. And I sat by this dude because this dude was like my best friend. Was supposed to be like my best friend. Now, this dude... He ain't my best friend after that day. Not no more. I barely remember this dude's name. So what you call, dude snitched on me, and that's that story. I'm talking about, like, you should have seen, bro. I'm talking about my leg. Like, I didn't wear shorts for like a smooth 2 weeks, bro. I had a bruise. I had like one of them fat bruises. Like, this is the worst whooping yet, bro. All right, man. So the next story time is the time I stole cereal from the cafeteria. Ooh-wee. This was worse than I don't think it was worse. I think it was about the same. But this time I got three whoopings in a day. Three whoopings in one day. Ooh-wee. My butt cheeks was on fire. Like, you know when you first get a whooping and then, hold up. Why's my controller shaking? But hey, yeah. All right, so I go to the cafeteria and this is the morning time. Anyway. Hey, I ain't even gonna lie to y'all, I'm a little rusty, bro. Now, you see how the way I was building, that was a panic build. And, alright, so, we finna get to the story time. So, I went through the lunch line, grabbed my tray, and you know how you gotta hand the lunch lady your money, and then she put it on the little, her little, what you call thing, and I pop out and be like, thank you. So, yeah, I get a lady a $10 bill, right? So, she puts it in there, I grab my lunch and go. So, I come back, and I already know I got money on my account. So, I tried to get a cereal, and lady was like, you can't get that, sir. And I was like, I just put money in my thing. And I put my little pin in. You know when you're elementary school, you gotta put that little pin in. Can't just scan your ID like in high school. So, I put my pin in, and she's like, all right, you got $10. And I was like, okay. She's like, but you can't get the cereal. I was like, why? She's like, you can only get it one time. And I was like, just take it off my little money, because it was only like 50 cents. Like, what is them little itty-bitty cups of things? And then I was like, all right. Top of the back. And then, so I go finish my food, and you know a boy's still hungry, bro. So I go back, and I try to go to the next lunch league, because you know how they have the two lines? So yeah, I come back, and a lady was like, go ahead, take it. So I grab the cereal, and I walk out. And then lady was like, you can't grab that, sir. And I was like, lady just told me I could. So she was like, put that back. So I put it back. And you know me, I'm a bad little kid. I didn't care. So I walk back in there like this, like, you know, on your tiptoes, like be sneaking. So I walk in there, grab the cereal, put it under my shirt like this, under my shirt, and I try to walk out like a G. But nah, that ain't, lunch lady had other plans. She did not let that happen that day. So I grab it, right? And she was like, sir, how many times do I have to tell you? Put that back. So, bruh, and then I grabbed it, and I started running back to my table. And then I didn't make it far because lunch lady was like right on my tail. And then, so I make it back to my table. I sit down, like, I duck through like the little crowd, like behind the little people that push the little trash cans. Yeah. So I hide behind them, and then she's looking for me. And I hid behind them, and I went and sit down. And I'm eating my cereal. And then, you know how they got cameras all over the school, so there was no getting away with stealing this lunch thing. So I try my best. But so I get one call. So I get my what's called. So I get called down to the thing. And you know how they be on the intercom. Excuse me, class. May you please send Quentin Block down to the AP's office? And I'm thinking, like, I already know what I'm finna go for. Lunch lady snitched on me. So I go down there. And then I was like, yes, y'all sent me down here. And then they was like, sir, they was like, Mr. Black. And I was like, yes, ma'am. And then she was like, did you steal a bowl of cereal this morning? And I ain't even gonna lie to the lady. I said yes, just like this, I said yes. So lady was like, all right, you know you're gonna get in trouble for this. I'm gonna have to call your mom. I was like, no. Crying and stuff. And then, so they call my mom. And then keep in mind, this is like a month or two apart from when I first got my first whooping for throwing the apple down the toilet. But yeah, so they call my mom again, and then they was like, Miss Lowe, your son Quentin Black is in here again. in the AP's office. We're gonna have to give him a referral, and he's gonna have to go to ISS again. And she's like, all right, I'll handle when I get home. Same thing. Same thing happened. I get home and ask you how your day is at school, and you already know that. That's when the stuff hit the fan. Like, you finna get your cheeks tore up. So, I go home. Already know what's gonna happen. I drop my bag, but you open the thing, and we got this little door hook. So you put your bag on the hook, and my mom walked around the corner, because it's a hallway, and you walk around the corner, and she's like, you already know what time it is. And I was like, I know. So I go out there, and you already know I gotta drop the pants, man. And she grabbed the belt, and she did just like this. She was like, hold on. She was like. They'd be like, started going in on my butt cheeks, going in. Ain't knowing your family, your parents tell all your business. So they tell your grandma, your uncle, your auntie Nisa, your cousin Joe, your uncle Billy, all of them. You know, all of them. They tell everybody in the family. So this happened to be on a bad day. So my grandma came into town and she was staying with us. And so she came in town and she's like, you know how to tell grandma and your stepdad, right? I was like, No, crying and stuff, begging her. And then, you know that wasn't gonna work. So, they told everybody in the family. And then, so, my stepdad go home, off the job. First thing he did was have to whoop me. And you know, when your parents come home and they yelling because they ain't do the dishes or something like that, and they already mad because they done had a bad day at work or something. Stressful day at work. It was like that. So, I get an even worse whooping than what it was probably gonna be if you had a good day at work. So, I get my butt cheeks tore up, man, and then my grandma come into town. We go pick up from the airport, and I'm crying just back to this, like, you know, eyes be all red, and this was like one of the whoopings where you'd be like, I'm leaving, packing my bags, and I ain't never coming back. Yeah, that kind of wrong. I'm packing my bags, and I ain't never coming back. It was like one of those whoopings. So I go, we go pick up my grandma, right, and then we get back to the house, my stepdad tear up my cheeks. And then my grandma was like, why are you getting whooping? And I told her why, because I ain't finna lie. And then, my grandma, I had never seen this in her life. She got, her face got red. She got so mad. She got the belt and started going ham, bruh. Ham on the butt cheeks, bruh. Talking about, she was tearing them up. I'm laying on the ground, trying to, you know how like, try to dodge the head sister? The belt falling down. But you know how, and then she was just tearing up, bro. Like, this time there was no getting out of it. No getting out of it. That was the only time I ever got whooped by my grandma, bro. And this was the worst whooping of my life. Like, this hurt my heart, bro. Like, she really whooped me. Like, I'm really close to my grandma, bro. And that really hurt me, bro. Like, she really whooped me. Like, she tore me up. And that was really the only times I really got whooped, bro. Like, a bad whooping, bro. Like a bad whooping. I might have another story time for y'all, but those really the two only times, like the worst whoopings. I'm gonna do another story time. Comment down below what y'all want next, bro. This is the end of the video. I'm just gonna record myself playing this game, bro. Like, you know how all the YouTubers be? I'm gonna be like, damn, for that day. So, I'm finna get to this, man. I'm finna go to Loot Lake. You already know me. All about the loot, baby. So, comment down below if y'all are ready for school, because I'm not ready for school, man. I don't know about y'all. I'm gonna do a first day of school vlog. Hopefully, it's live. Yeah. Y'all finna go with me for a day? Oh my god, bro.